All. Today, I, Chhaya Dubey, am present in front of you all to deliver a presentation on Make in India initiative, in which today we are going to talk about the electrical machinery sector. So, first of all, let us talk about the main agenda of this Make in India initiative. The main agenda of this initiative is to facilitate investments, foster innovation, enhance skill development, protect intellectual property, and build best-in-class manufacturing infrastructure in the country. So, the flow of today's presentation is going to be like, first of all, we are going to have the introduction of the what this sector aims for, why this sector, and then the reasons to invest in this sector, the recent announcements which has been done in this particular sector. After that, we are going to talk about the statistics, the exact numbers which we have for this particular sector, the FDI policy related to electrical machinery sector. Then after the sector policy, then after the financial support, investment opportunities, foreign investors, and then we look on to the SWOT analysis of this particular sector. So, the electrical machinery sector, why it has been chosen as one of the most important sectors by Government of India? Because India is the world's third largest producer and third largest consumer of electricity. The national electric grid in India has an installed capacity of 375.32 gigawatts as of 31st December 2020. As the consumption of electricity is this high, it is more than obvious that there is a consumption of electrical machinery as well. And that is why this sector has been chosen as the one of the most important sector. So now for the broader segment, this electrical equipment industries has been classified into two main segments. First one is the generation equipment, under which lies boilers, turbines, generators. These are the electrical machinery involved in the generation sector. Then after comes the transmission and distribution sectors, which involves transformers, cables, transmission lines, etc. So the electrical equipment market production is estimated to touch $100 billion by 2022, and this only particular sector contributes to about 1.5% to overall GDP. The sector is projected to provide employment both directly and indirectly to 3.5 million people by 2022. So, after having the basic introduction of this particular sector, let us move ahead and look forward to the reasons to invest in this sector. The reasons to invest in this particular sector, and that too in India. Let me take you to a brief overview of the particular reasons of investing in electrical machinery sector in India. Indian electrical equipment industry plans to make India as the preferred destination for producing of electrical equipment. By 2022, domestic demand for generation equipment is expected to reach $25 to $30 billion. For transmission and distribution sector, it is estimated to reach $70 to $75 billion. Market-oriented reforms such as target for power for all plans to add 93 gigawatts by 2022 is expected to generate huge demand for power transmission and distribution equipment. Incentives are also being provided for power generation, and they are definitely going to increase the demand for electrical machinery. Indian manufacturers are becoming competitive in terms of product designs, manufacturing, and testing facilities. Capacity creation in sectors such as infrastructure, power, mining, oil and gas refineries, steel, automotive, and consumer durables are driving demand in the engineering sector. The government also plans to establish in electrical equipment industry clusters along with building strong support infrastructure. Basically, what government aims to do in this particular sector is it aims to, you know, cluster all the industry, industry experts to come along and build the sector here in India as well. So the recent investment in this sector that was made on 19th of January 2021, MeitY may keep 7,500 crore INR outlay for IT hardware manufacturing under PLI scheme. This will facilitate hardware in IT industry. This was the recent announcement for this particular sector. After that comes the statistics, the exact numbers we are going to talk about. So the total foreign direct investment equity inflows in the electrical equipment sector stood at $8.5 billion from April 2000 till December 2019. By 2022, the installed power capacity in India is expected to reach 350 gigawatts from 243 gigawatts in 2014. The heavy industry subsectors provides direct employment to 0.5 million people, indirect employment to 1 million people, and over 5 million across the entire value chain. Now comes the FDI policy. So first of all, let us focus on the FDI. What is this FDI policy stands for? It basically involves the, this is the attractive feature for the foreign investors to come and invest in India for this particular sector. So there has been a very, very, 100% FDI is allowed under the automatic route in the electrical machinery sector, subject to all applicable regulations and laws. The cumulative FDI equity inflow in the electrical equipment industry is $9,819.30 million during the period April 2000 to September 2020. This constitutes 1.96 of the total FDI inflow received across sector. So this number can be termed as the big one. Alone, this sector is contributing this much to the FDI inflow we have. Now, after that comes the sector policy. This sector must be having some policies to attract the applicants to come and join for this a particular manufacturing industry. So first one is the delicensing policy. The electrical machinery industry has been delicensed along with 100% FDI allowed in this sector. This has facilitated the entry of major global players into the electrical machinery industry in India. Next one is the what we have the vision for 2022 for this particular sector. It is as we have discussed above as well, that the vision is to make India a preferred country for the production of electrical equipment. It also aims to achieve a production target of $100 billion by balancing the trade deficit. I would like to talk about this trade deficit term over here. That what is this trade deficit? So exactly the thing is that as of now, we are able to produce that much that we need to import some items as well. But what is the vision for 2022 is that we need to balance this trade deficiency. That is, we need to manufacture as much that if at all we are able to consume it on our own, but then also we have that much of surplus amount that we can export as well. So that is the vision for 2022. So now for this vision to be achieved, for this particular mission to be achieved, for this trade deficiency to be balanced out, we have to focus on these particular sectors, that is technology and R&D, so that we can have our class manufacturing, lowering of custom duties on a range of equipment, so that we can export and import our manufactured goods to other countries as well, setting up of the electrical equipment skill development council, so that we can have more and more number of skilled laborers with us, and that is how the productivity is going to be increased. Establishment of electrical equipment industry clusters on this particular topic we have discussed above as well. Enhancement of products testing infrastructure in the country and providing credit support to economically less developed export markets. Then comes the financial support. If at all we want the investors to come and invest in this particular sector, there has to be some financial support from the government as well. Either it is the state government or the central government. So let us look forward to what financial support we are providing in this particular sector. First of all, there is the state incentives. Apart from the above, each state in India offers additional incentives for industrial projects. Incentives are in areas like subsidized land costs, relaxation in stamp duty, exemption on the sale lease of land, patent subsidy, power tariffs incentives, a concessional rate of interest on loans, investment subsidies, tax incentives, backward area subsidies, special incentive packages for mega projects, and etc. So what basically we are doing in this state incentive, every state is like attracting the consumers, attracting the basically the players of this market to come and invest in their particular state. For this investment purpose, what they are, what the state is basically doing, they are providing, they are actually fascinating the users to come and invest in there. Well, how they are doing that? That they are giving them subsidized land costs, relaxation in stamp duty, exemption of the sale and lease of land, patent subsidy. That is how the states are attracting. Now comes the exports incentives. Various incentives are provided under Export Promotion Capital Goods Scheme, Duty Remission Scheme, Focus Products Scheme, Special Focus Product Scheme, Focus Market Scheme. So under these export incentives, what the thing is that suppose we are focusing on one particular product that this particular product needs to be such position that this needs to be export more and more. So for that particular product, what we are going to do, we need to provide the export incentives on that particular product. So what does this do? That it attracts more and more number of consumers to come and then invest in their particular sector. Skill development, the steps taken, we all know this skill development, that there has been Skill India development programs started by the state government. And what does they aim to? What does they aim at? They aim at giving us more and more number of skilled laborers to enhance the productivity. Then after comes the area-based incentives. The government approved 15 SEZs for the engineering sector, and electrical machinery is the part of the sector. Further development of Delhi-Mumbai industrial sector is expected to provide a big boost to the engineering sector. Then after come the investment opportunities. Now, if at all we are providing such great opportunities, such great reasons to come and invest in this particular sector, the one should also know what are the investment opportunities he is going to look forward to. So as I already told you that this sector has been broadly classified in under two segments, that is, one is the generation equipment and second is the transmission and distribution equipment. So here are all listed investment opportunities in which one can look forward to. So the generation equipment, if one needs to go for the generation equipment, he can invest in boilers, turbines, generators. Then after the, if at all he wants to invest in transmission equipments, there comes the transformers, the distribution equipments, comes the switch gears and controls, and for others there are electrical motors, wires and cables. So these are the particular foreign investors we have as of now for this particular sector, which can be stated as MHI, that is a company from Japan, Hitachi, that is again from Japan, Babcock, that is from UK, Alstom France, Toshiba Japan, Alessandro Italy, Colfax Corporation USA, Schneider Electric France, Legrand France, GE USA. So now that we are all familiar with all the policies, start support of this particular sector, let us have a look at the SWOT analysis of this sector on the basis of the points discussed above. We all know the importance of SWOT analysis. So that is how, after going through all the particular sector, I have come to the conclusion of it in the form of the SWOT analysis of electrical machinery sector. So first of all, the strength of this particular sector is that the demand for electricity with such huge population of ours is going to increase is going to definitely increase in the future. So there is actually, if at all we look forward to our future, there is a very shining one we can look forward to. And the existence of proper expert staff in public and private companies and active use of recommendation system. Now comes the weakness. The first weakness that comes for this particular sector by which no other sector has also been untouched is the corruption. The corruption in India. Basically, what happens is when there are some subsidies involved in this particular sector and everything. So what is there on paper is never the same in reality. That is where corruption plays its role. And we somehow not been able to achieve our target for this particular reason. Then after comes the weaknesses, that is, we are not that much using our modern technologies and proper methodologies for maintenance program. Then after comes the non-existence authorized strategy for electricity expansion planning with economic, social and cultural issues. Then after comes the opportunities. So whole society depending on electricity, and it is extending day by day electricity substitution instead of other energy types. What we are doing is we are substituting other energy devices with electrical equipments. That is definitely going to be a very, very wide opportunity for all those investing in this particular sector. So that is going to be a great opportunity. Now comes the threats, technical and non-technical issues in transmission and distribution networks. Then after comes the drought effects on operations of hydropower plants. Then after comes the monopolization existence in electricity marketing. These points can act as the threats in electrical machinery sector. So that is all for the presentation. Thank you.